A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. Actually, right here, right now, on our planet, leaders of some of the most powerful countries are talking space. Talking, no less, about weaponizing it. In July, French President Emmanuel Macron announced the establishment of a space command.
La nouvelle doctrine spatiale militaire qui m'a été proposée par la ministre et que j'ai approuvée permettra d'assurer notre défense de l'espace et par l'espace. Nous renforcerons notre connaissance de la situation spatiale. Nous protégerons mieux nos satellites, y compris de manière active.
That followed a similar announcement by the US president last year.
I'm hereby directing the Department of Defense and Pentagon to immediately begin the process necessary to establish a space force as the sixth branch of the armed forces. That's a big statement.
And some military leaders agree that space is now a battlefront.
Space is one of our vital national interests in the sense of our use of space, our operations in space, and it is becoming a contested warfighting domain, and we have got to adapt to that reality.
The Pentagon's Defense Intelligence Agency released a report in February saying China and Russia are developing space weapons such as anti-satellite missiles. Other countries, including India, North Korea, and Iran, have military space programs. The 1967 Outer Space Treaty, signed by 132 countries, forbids the deployment of weapons of mass destruction in space, as well as weapons of any kind on the moon and other celestial bodies. But conventional weapons are not banned, and the UN has raised the alarm at the prospect of future space wars, which could affect us all. Egypt's representative to the UN Disarmament and International Security Committee has expressed the concerns of the Arab, African, and non-aligned groups.
Taking into consideration the extreme fragility and volatility of the outer space environment, it must not be allowed to turn into another battlefield or a scene for military conflicts that could have catastrophic implications.
Satellites are critical to such a wide range of applications, from communications to international development, that they are a benefit to all humans. And the US operates the most satellites by far. Yet for some, the sky is never the limit.
When it comes to defending America, it is not enough to merely have an American presence in space. We must have American dominance in space. So important.
But if space is to remain for the benefit of all, as the UN intends, is it now time to ban the use of all weapons there? Adam Pletz, The Newsmakers.